My dad and my mom, they live in Uttarakhand, in northern part of India. My dad and my mom got married when he was, I think, 18 year old, and my mom was 15 year old. So I came from that background, whereas like men are ruling their families. So man is very important, and women are like less important. But my dad, even though he has 6 daughters, he never let us down. He said, do whatever you want to do in your life, okay? I won't stop you. I think my mom inspired my dad because my mom is a very strong woman. She always, you know, tell to my dad that I want to educate my daughter. Please don't stop them. And my dad said, okay. My mom was really, really sick. We take her to different temples, like Sikh temples and Muslim temples, and like Hindu temples. And we couldn't get any answer and any relief from my mom. So one day, my sister Anjali met her friend. Her name is Manisha. So she said, so we go to this church. Why don't you take your mom here? Maybe the pastor can heal your mom. So I said, okay, let me go first. So when I went to that church first time, it was in Easter time. And the pastor was, you know, telling about Jesus Christ. I cried that day when they were worshiping him. I did not hear anything, what they were singing, what they were talking. I just heard one voice that he died for your sin. And that really, I was shocked. I was like, how can he die for my sin? After 1 year, I was coming from my college. I had an exam. And as I was walking, I saw Manisha. So she was standing on the road and I was like, what are you doing here? So then she told me that, you know, I'm waiting for the elders. Then I was like, elder, what do you mean? What elder means? So she said, I also don't know. but I'm waiting for the two people who are wearing badge, and they're wearing white shirt and black pant, and they're coming to my home. So I said to Manisha that I'm going home, and she said that, are you coming to my home? So I said, no, I'm not coming. I'm going to my home because I have to prepare for my exam. As I start walking, I heard a voice. Hi, sisters. So I looked back. So they invited me. They said, no, sister, we are going to Manisha's house. Would you like to come? So I said, no, I'm already tired. And tomorrow is also a big exam for me. I want to go home and prepare for that. As I was sitting down, I heard a voice that you should go. I was so shocked, like what voice I'm hearing. And I was ignoring that voice till 15 minutes. After like 15 minutes, I was like, okay, I think I should go. I told my younger sister, her name is Ashu. I said, Ashu, let's go. We are going to Manisha's house. So like she said, why? And I said, let's go, come with me. So I went to their house, I knocked the door, and I went inside. So elder said, I know that you will come. They started, you know, teaching about Joseph Smith's vision. He was also searching the truth. Joseph Smith sees Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ. My body was so calm. My mind, my heart was so calm. I feel like this is the right place. Like, this is it. I never heard about Heavenly Father before. I know that Jesus Christ is there, but I don't know that we have Father also, Heavenly Father. So after they finish the teaching, and they give me their card. They said, sister, this is our church and this is our number. And our church start in afternoon around 2 o'clock. So would you like to come? So I said, elder, I'm already going to a church. So they said, okay, but try to come to our church. So next Sunday, I went to the Pentecostal church. And then in the afternoon, I went to the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. So in the evening, I was, you know, sitting in my roof. I look up in the sky. I said, whoever you are, tell me what is the truth. I'm struggling here. I don't know what to do. Like, you know, somebody saying, do this, and somebody saying, do that. Where I need to go? I said, whoever you are, if you're real God, tell me what I need to do. I slept and I saw a dream. In my dream, I saw that the elders are giving me baptism. I went to the water and came out. I don't know how to say it, but it's just literally feel to me, it's real. And that time I know, this is my answer. I call elder in the morning. I said, elder, I'm ready for the baptism. So after we all get baptized on December, my mom died. My hope and everything was, I feel like everything is gone. Because we are so close to our mom. Even though I joined this church, I have a hope that my mom will be healed and she'll be like before she was. And I have really much hope that, you know, that Heavenly Father will save her. But like she died. They talk about, you know, plan of salvation. I know that I can meet my mom again. That is the way Heavenly Father was preparing me for that. He was preparing me to find truth. I think this is all planned because I have the testimony. He was preparing me for that day, and I can feel that I can meet my mom again. If you're searching for the truth for your own life, ask God as I ask, as Joseph Smith asked. You will get your answer by Holy Ghost. I felt it in my heart. I listened to that voice. And I feel so happy to be a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. And I want that everyone feel the same, the way I do. Thank you.